Today's topic is superposition theorem. First of all, we'll discuss about what is a linear circuit. Why? Because superposition theorem is only applicable to linear circuit. Then we will discuss about the statement of the superposition theorem and we'll understand that using an example. Then we will solve a numerical problem so as to understand how to solve any question using this superposition theorem. And towards the end of this video, we have an assignment for you. So watch till the end. Now you already know that to apply superposition theorem in any network, that network has to be a linear circuit, right? So this is why in this slide we'll discuss about what is a linear circuit. So a linear circuit is what? A linear circuit is a circuit whose parameters are not changed with respect to voltage and current. So if you take this circuit for example, in this circuit a resistor is connected along with this voltage source. Now we want to find out the IV characteristics for this resistance. So this is why we have connected the voltmeter across this resistance, and since we want to measure the current that is passing through this resistance, so that is why we have connected an ammeter in series with this resistance. Clear? Now if we draw this IV characteristics for this resistance, we will find out that this will follow this linear path. So that is, this is linear. So we can easily see that the graph is a linear graph, right? So this is why resistor is a linear element. And whenever in a circuit linear elements are present, then that circuit is considered to be as linear circuit. Clear? So this circuit is a linear circuit. So that means superposition theorem is applicable over here. But if we have chosen a diode in place of this resistor, that means the same circuit. Let's say this is Vs. Now if we want to find out the IV characteristics, you will find out that the graph will look like this. So that means this is a nonlinear graph, right? So that means this diode is a nonlinear element. So since this nonlinear element is present in this circuit, so this means this is a nonlinear circuit and superposition theorem is not applicable in this circuit. Clear? So now it is the time to understand the statement of the superposition theorem. So what is the statement? The statement is, in a linear circuit containing several sources, the response in any branch is equal to the algebraic sum of the responses due to each independent sources acting separately when all other sources are deactivated. Now what does that mean actually? Is that, let's say you have this circuit and you want to find out this branch current, that is I2. Clear? So that becomes your output response for this circuit. So output response. Clear? Now if you want to find out this I2 using superposition theorem, the superposition theorem says that first of all you have to find out the contribution of I2 due to this voltage source. That is your first step. And on the second step, what you have to find out is the contribution of this I2 due to this current source. Clear? So step one, you have to find out the contribution due to voltage source. Second step, you have to find out contribution due to current source. And then step three, you just add those contributions. Clear? And that becomes your answer. Hope you understand. And if you haven't understand till now, let us solve a question and then you will understand that. What is the question? The question says you have to find out the current through this 10 ohm resistor. Clear? Using superposition theorem. So what we will do, we will find out the contribution of this I due to this 10 volt source, that's our step number one. In step number two, we will also find out the contribution of I due to this 20 ampere current source, right? So by now we will know the contribution of I due to this and due to this as well, right? And there is no other sources present in this circuit. So now what we will do at step 3, we will just add these contributions algebraically. Why algebraically? Because we have to consider the direction of the current, right? So this is why we will add those two contributions algebraically, right? So now our step one. Step one is what? Step one says deactivate all the independent sources except one source, right? And how we will deactivate that independent sources is by their internal resistances. So for this step one, we will consider that this 10 volt is active, right? So 10 volt, so at step one, we will consider that this is active and we will deactivate this, okay? And now how will we deactivate this current source? By its internal resistance, right? So now we have to remember, take a note that the internal resistance Rin is equals to infinite for ideal current source, right? And Rin is equals to zero for ideal voltage source, right? So for step one, our circuit would become this 10 volt source is active, this is your 5 ohm resistance, this is your 10 ohm resistance, this is again your 10 ohm resistance, and in between these two nodes the current source was present, right? But since we want to deactivate this current source, so we will replace this current source with its internal resistance. That is, our internal over here is infinite, that means this will be an open path, right? So that means in this branch there will be no current flowing through this, right? So the total amount of current will pass through this, okay? So let's name this current to be I dash, and this is our 10 volt, this is our 5, this is our 10, right? So R equivalent becomes what? R equivalent becomes 5 plus 10, because those are kept in series, so that means 15 ohm. So what is your I dash? I dash is equals to 10 divided by 15, that means 2 divided by 3 amps. And what is the direction of this I dash? Is in this direction, clear? Downwards. Now we will find out the contribution of I due to this 20 ampere current source, right? So step 2 is what? At step 2, we will consider that this 20 ampere current source is active, right? So 20 amps current source is active. So this is active, and we have to deactivate this 10 volt voltage source. So our final circuit will become what? This is our 5 ohm. Now in between this becomes your final circuit. So this is your 5 ohm resistance, this is your 10 ohm resistance, this is again your 10 ohm resistance, and this is your 20 amp current source that is active for this step. But in between these two nodes the voltage source was present, and since we are deactivating this voltage source, so we will replace this voltage source with its internal resistance. And we have already discussed that the internal resistance of an ideal voltage source is zero. Since the internal resistance of an ideal voltage source is zero, that means that will become a short circuited path. So it's a shorted path. Now we have to find out this current, right? Let's name this current I double dash, because we are in this step, we are actually finding out the contribution of this current due to this source. Now by applying current division rule, I'm actually assuming that you know this current division rule. So the I double dash would become, so I double dash will be the source current, that is 20 ampere into the other resistance, that is this 5 ohm, divided by sum of these two resistances, that is 5 plus 10. Why these two resistances? Because these two are kept in parallel, so current will divide only in between these two resistances, right? So I double dash becomes 100 divided by 15, that becomes 20 divided by 3, right? Amps. And what is the direction of this current? This is also flowing in the downward direction, right? So step 3 is what? Step 3 is find the output response by adding algebraically all the individual output responses due to independent sources. So that means in this step we will actually add this I dash and I double dash to get our desired I, right? So our I becomes, I dash was 2 divided by 3 plus, and I double dash is 20 divided by 3. This is your in amps. So that would become 22 divided by 3 amps. And what is the final direction of this I? Is in the downward direction. Why? Since this I dash was also flowing in this downward direction and I double dash was also flowing in this downward direction. So these two current will add up. This is why in the statement it has been written algebraic sum, right? So that becomes your answer. Hope now the statement is clear to you. So I think by now you must have understood what is the superposition theorem and how to apply this superposition theorem to solve any question. So now it is your turn to solve a question. So this question is for you. Now what is the question? The question says the circuit is given, using superposition theorem find out the current passing through 1 ohm resistor, that is this resistor, alright? So you have to find out this I current. So how will you solve? That is, you have in this circuit you have three sources, right? This is an independent source, this is an independent source, and this is an independent source, right? So in this circuit three sources are there. So in this circuit you will have three contributions of this current, right? One contribution will be of due to this, one contribution will be due to this, and one contribution will be due to this. And finally you add all those contributions and you'll get the answer. But always remember the direction of the final current, right? And this is the end part of this video. And if you think that this video is helpful for you, so like this video and share it with your friends. So thanks for watching. See you in the next video.